revolutionary talk for revolutionary times. Promoting peace, liberty, and prosperity around the clock. LibertyTalk.fm.
Welcome to Medicine on Call, where it's all about living the solutions. This is Dr. Elena George, and I have an important show today. I think it's a little bit different from what we normally do because we're living in very interesting times. I think everybody turns on the TV and radio these days and hears about opioid addiction and how it's really taken over whole segments of our society. And another thing that people hear about is medical marijuana, and I don't think a lot of people actually know what that really means. We've heard it be passed in Colorado and other states, and in Florida, I think they have, I don't know if it's new, but we're going to ask our guest so that she can give us the update on exactly what's going on in Florida, because I think that's cutting edge. And I think Florida was actually the epicenter of the opioid crisis, and the fact that medical marijuana and marijuana in general is being used for medicinal purposes, I think puts a whole new spin on how we can break this addiction that our country has to something that's toxic. I believe in natural approach to everything, and if we can use our own bodies to heal, that's the way we should do it. And I was intrigued when I found the Tetra Health Centers. I was alerted to them, and I looked it up, and I thought, I have to have the president on, and this is Ms. Tracilea Young, who's the president of Tetra Health. She's got a very interesting past, everything from being a midwife to being an entrepreneur and now starting the Tetra Health Centers. So Ms. Young, I want to thank you so much for coming on, because you're really a pioneer, I think, and I wanted to definitely have you on so you could let us all know exactly what the cutting edge is for our healthcare system, especially with pain management and chronic disease. So I want to welcome you to the show.
Thank you. I appreciate you having me. And, you know, I agree with what you said there. You know, this is the beginning of an emerging market. There's so many people that are just uneducated as to the benefits of medical marijuana, but they're also uneducated as to the damage that the opioids and so many other medicines are doing to their body. You know, there's side effects that, you know, the list goes on and on. And if we as a community and as a whole can educate those in need of something that is natural and can heal our bodies without all the side effects, that they're doing themselves a great service. And, you know, that's why Tetra Health Centers is here, is because the need is huge. And you hit the nail on the head when you said that Florida is the epicenter of the opioid crisis. You know, we've got close to 22 million people in this state, and there is a very large percentage of that population that are dealing with some sort of opioid addiction. You've got somewhere in the area of more than 151 people die daily from that. So let's educate, let's serve, and let's use natural medicine to deal with whatever health crisis, you know, we've got in our lives.
You know, I was listening to one of the interviews that you did, and the host asked the provocative question, which I think sums up everything. You know, there's never been a death from marijuana use. No one can say the same thing. You just gave us devastating information about the number of people and how many deaths there are daily. That's an epidemic. That's tragic. And I think it's silent. I think people from a societal standpoint think about somebody on the street, somebody who's not part of society, and these are the people that it affects. That's far from true, isn't it?
It is 100%. You know, and the other part that goes right alongside of that is, you know, once a patient is given a diagnosis and they're, you know, given a prescription to deal with that diagnosis, oftentimes that brings on, you know, the detrimental side effects. And more common than not, the patient will go back to the doctor and describe this side effect that they're experiencing, and they get a new prescription for something additional. And that just goes on and on. You know, we see daily patients that come in with just Excel spreadsheets listing all the medications that they're on, dealing with all these conditions, but, you know, the majority of them are truly just side effects of one or more of the medications that they've been put on. So, you know, I feel like as a whole, our community has been served a real disservice mm-hmm. in medicine. So I do agree with you.
Well, I know that you have experience with ambulatory surgery centers. Am I correct?
Yes.
And in terms of pain management, I mean, that's one of the places as a surgeon I think of postoperative pain and patients who have the need for some sort of relief. I would think medical marijuana would be amazing, a godsend to those people. You don't have kidney issues with, like, the non-steroidals. You're not going to get addicted like the opioids. And it actually does actually help pain, because I don't think the opioids actually do. I think it's the Tylenol in the prescriptions, you know, the mix that really gets rid of the pain. The other is just to knock you out and make you doped up. But what's your impression of using marijuana for things like chronic or post-operative or acute pain, for that matter?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. You know, I think the first and foremost important rule for anybody who is investigating using medical cannabis for pain control or any other thing is to start low with a low dose and go slow, meaning once you take your first dose, you've got to give your body time to accustom to this new medicine. So often, you know, I've heard so many people describe our society as the microwave society. You know, we want instant results. We want instant gratification, and certainly we're going to want instant pain relief. Well, depending on where we're at with, you know, the deficiency in each one of us, our own endocannabinoid receptor system, it's going to take a different amount of medical marijuana, and it's also going to take a different amount of time for our body to respond to it. So you've got to just start with a low dose, give yourself enough time so that you can figure out what exactly your body will respond to in a positive manner, and then just maintain that. There wouldn't be any need to increase or decrease mm-hmm. once you've found, you know, your sweet spot, so to speak. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the most important thing. But absolutely, you know, I've dealt with many patients that have gone through surgeries and different traumatic experiences, and, you know, the first thing I've got to do with most of them is educate them on the safety of medical marijuana and to the fact you spoke that there's not one documented death from medical marijuana. Most of the time what you'll see is somebody that's taken too much too fast mm-hmm. and they end up feeling very sick or they sleep. And, you know, we can avoid all of that with the Start Low and Go Slow program.
I mean, I think about all of the, how much different this is than the, for the people who are heroin addicted and they were on methadone. That was a complete different ballgame where people were addicted to the thing that was supposed to get them off of heroin. And it became just as big a problem as the drug itself. This is completely different. You're not talking about somebody not being able to work, not being able to function. It's really almost like it works in tandem with the system if you do it correctly.
That's exactly right. And, you know, you may or may not know this, but there are many programs, you know, Alcoholics Anonymous, Drug Addicts Anonymous, all of these different programs are actually utilizing medical cannabis to help these people wean themselves off of these strong addictive drugs. The way that medical cannabis works is it will enhance those drugs so that you need less and less of it over time. Mm-hmm. So you can wean yourself off comfortably. And by the time you're off of those opioids, you know, you, you really are just relying on the medical marijuana for whatever pain control or health condition relief that you're dealing with.
That's awesome. Hey, let's take our first break. You're listening to Medicine on Call. This is Dr. George from Medicine on Call. Each week I speak about our healthcare system and the problems with it. One of the main problems is the doctor-patient relationship. I've found that patients really crave time, the time to ask their doctor questions, and physicians crave the time to answer those questions in a thorough manner. Towards that end, Peachtree Ear, Nose, and Throat Center is pleased to announce a new video telemedicine service. We now offer consultation for second opinions and for people who'd like to learn more and ask questions about how to navigate the healthcare system in a cost-effective and efficient manner. Go to peachtreeentcenter.video-visits.com to learn more. From treatment of sinusitis with balloon dilation to minimally invasive office procedures to correct snoring, Peachtree ENT Center offers state-of-the-art care. We also specialize in price transparency. You'll know the cost of our ENT services before they're rendered, whether you have a high deductible plan or no insurance at all. Make an appointment today to find out why Peachtree ENT Center is where patient care counts. Call 404-591-9100 or visit us at peachtreeentcenter.com.
You're listening to Medicine on Call, where healthcare, business, and current events connect.
Welcome back to Medicine on Call. We're speaking with Ms. Tracilea Young, the president of Tetra Health Centers, somebody who is a visionary and a pioneer, and someone who's about changing the paradigm. Instead of us doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result, I think she's had the courage to go out there and create a space where people can get their lives back, where they can become productive members of society. And not just, we talked a lot in the first segment about the opioid issue, but you mentioned other things, alcoholism, and what about things like chronic disease? And let me, before I stop you, does the marijuana affect the same receptors as the opioids? Is that why it's effective and you can actually kind of fool the body into thinking that it's happy?
Well, so each one of us inherently has endocannabinoid receptor system. And one of the reasons marijuana is so beneficial is because it interacts with the receptors. And quite often, let me back up a little bit. The body normally produces cannabinoids and endocannabinoids, and they bind with the receptors. What we're finding is that people that have a deficiency in their endocannabinoid receptor system benefit because they're able to bind to the receptors in the cannabis. So I don't know if I've answered your question, but where people have deficiencies, when you introduce cannabis, it actually encourages more production of those receptors.
Okay.
So and it just replaces the ones that are non-functioning or they're deficient in their function.
Got you. So it upregulates and actually normalizes the system, essentially.
Correct.
Okay, got you. And that's actually fixing a problem, you know, for lack of a better way to put it. So unlike these medications that we just talked about, these pharmaceuticals where it's a controlled poison, this is actually working naturally to improve something that needs to be there. That's a whole different take on it, isn't it?
Exactly. And, you know, when you look at it that way, you know, you've got, Western medicine, and certainly there's a time and a place for all of that. But most oftentimes, you know, it's more of a Band-Aid, and that's not what we're looking for here. We're looking for healing, and we're looking for recovery, and we're looking for benefits. And that's all that I see when you introduce medical cannabis to a patient in need of some sort of, you know, rebuilding.
Well, what other medical conditions do you find that you treat out of your Tetra Health Centers?
The most common is PTSD. You know, we live in a world where we've got so many people who have, you know, boldly served our country and protected us, but yet they've dealt with some very, very serious situations that have, you know, affected them emotionally. So that I would say is our number one condition. But the most common ailments would be something like arthritis. Cancer is mm-hmm. absolutely a condition that benefits from cannabis. You've got chronic pain, which really is a subcategory for many different, you know, ailments and issues. Crohn's disease responds beautifully to cannabis. Epilepsy, fibromyalgia, glaucoma, HIV and AIDS, multiple sclerosis. Again, people with MS are really getting beautiful results when they introduce medical cannabis. And even something like nausea, you know, which is mm-hmm. typically the result of another condition. But cannabis can address that on its own, you know, and when you're dealing with nausea with a cancer patient, they're actually able to get their appetite back and nourish their body, you know, if they choose to go through chemo and radiation and those other treatments, their body becomes depleted of all energy because they are not able to eat, or what they do eat, they throw up, and the cannabis is able to eliminate the nausea and help them to keep that food down so that they can, you know, have the strength that they need to fight.
In terms of the different forms, everybody thinks about it as just smoking. But what other forms does it come in? Because it's not just that, is it?
No, it's not. Actually, there's a whole plethora of, we call them modalities, but those are just different ways that you can utilize it. So capsules are very common, and for me personally, and the pain that I deal with, that is my choice route. Works beautifully for me. I get at least 6 hours of pain control, and it's, you know, I take a capsule in the morning, and then I'm able to take another capsule before bed. Mm-hmm. We've got the vape pen for those that are comfortable with the smoking, and as of yet, the smoking the flower, or, you know, maybe rolling a joint, if you will, is the only modality that's prohibited in the state of Florida. But there are many people that are most comfortable with smoking, so a vape pen might work well for them. The beautiful benefit of vaping is that it goes to work, you know, almost immediately. Within just a few seconds, you're getting that pain relief. The probably the opposite of that is the fact that it's not going to last very long. So what we might encourage a patient to do would be to maybe use a vape pen to get that immediate pain control, perhaps when they're just waking up in the morning. And at the same time, or a few minutes after, they can take a capsule. And by the time the vape pain control has worn off, the capsule is just beginning to work. And it will, again, just sustain that pain control and keep that even for them throughout the day. Many of our patients are really liking the transdermal patches, a patch that you just stick on, and, you know, it is absorbed transdermally, and that will give you a long-term relief as well. You've got some patches that will give you about 24 hours pain relief, and there is one of the dispensaries that's got a patch that will give you 3 days of pain control. Mm. So that's pretty beautiful. I think probably one of the most common would be the tinctures and the concentrates that are sublingual. You've got topicals that are lotions and creams and salves. If you're looking at just CBD, something that wouldn't have the THC in it, you can get, you know, your teas and your different kinds of edibles with that. But though anything that includes THC is not yet been defined in the state of Florida. It's been allowable, but it's not legal in the sense that the state hasn't defined the parameters of how it will be packaged and what it will look like and the different, you know, available foods. So that is forthcoming. It's just not available yet.
So for the listeners, just to key in on THC versus the tinctures of the CBD oil in them, is there any, do you get a high from either on any of these things, or is that just a wives' tale?
Oh, no, that's absolutely correct. The CBD is the part of the plant that controls the body. So you're going to get your pain control. You're going to get, you know, like we talked about, help with alcoholism, Alzheimer's, things like that. Mm-hmm. When you introduce THC, we call that the part that deals with the head. It's neurological, and that's where you're going to feel that high, if you will. Now, personally, I believe that you've got to have both. Do I think you have to have a lot of THC? Absolutely not. Mm-hmm. Even the smallest amount of THC is going to give you the whole plant experience, and it's going to address whatever condition you're dealing with from the root of the source. So I agree with both parts. I think in pediatrics, you're going to want to deal with the majority of just CBD. There are a few cases where I think the THC is important, but in very, very micro doses.
Gotcha. So in order to go to somebody, I mean, this is not something that everybody can do and everybody should be dispensing, since what you described is a really, it's very complicated and it's very exact about the formulations, about the quality of what you're getting. Is that fair to say?
Exactly. It really is. And so we, you know, at Tetra Health Centers, we always encourage our patients to try all the different dispensaries because they're all going to have different products. They're all going to be created differently. And, you know, what one dispensary has for a capsule might not work as well for you as another dispensary's capsule. And the same is true with the patches and the creams and salves and even the vape pens. The one thing that I want to encourage patients to know is that we've had a few patients come back and maybe they say, you know, I've tried the vape pen, but it burns my throat or gives me a headache, or, you know, they may have, you know, a reaction to whatever product that they tried. And 99.9% of the time, it's not the cannabis that's affecting them negatively, but perhaps one of the products that they tried had some additives, maybe a flavoring or a coloring or a fragrance or something else as an additive added to it. And most likely that's what's causing that side effect that's so unpleasant for them. So we just encourage people to try all the dispensaries and find the one that works for them, find the product that works for them, and find the dosage that works for them so that they can get, you know, the whole goal is to have sustained pain or condition relief throughout the day and night rather than, you know, the roller coaster. You know, I feel great, then my meds wore off, and I've got to take it again and wait for it to work again. If you can find your sweet spot and your dispensary that works for you, you're going to have really fantastic results.
Well, that's an excellent point, and that's a really good time to take our next break. You're listening to Medicine on Call.
Health insurance was the promise of Obamacare. But for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. This is Dr. Elena George from Medicine on Call, and I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative allowed under Obamacare, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose, and with a maximum of $500 out-of-pocket per person and 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, you can rest assured knowing you and your family are protected. Coverage starts as low as $107 per month and also includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Liberty HealthShare puts you back in charge of your health. Visit them online at libertyoncall.org. Again, for a true affordable alternative to Obamacare, visit libertyoncall.org or call toll-free 1-800-714-6993 today.
Welcome back to Medicine on Call. This is Dr. Elena George and my special guest today, Ms. Tracilea Young, the president of Tetra Health Centers. And if people go to their website, www.tetrahealthcenters.com, that's T-E-T-R-A, healthcenters.com, and you can look at the website, the services. I mean, I'm really impressed. This is more than one location now that you have, or is it just that one in Tampa?
Well, we've got one in Tampa. We're opening up in the Villages here in the next, it'll be about 60 days. We're very excited about that location. And we've got some forecasted locations for the East Coast as well. You know, Boca Raton is going to be opening shortly. And there's, you know, several different locations that we've chosen trying to maximize, you know, the exposure so that patients are able to get to a doctor that has true compassion and wants to serve best, you know, as he can.
Mm-hmm.
So we will be statewide, but the state of Florida, I'm sure you've been following, has not been friendly to anybody in the cannabis industry. And so it's really been just one foot in front of the other, and we're all learning lessons and trying to be as effective as we can, you know, until the state really has clear boundaries and is really willing to allow us to serve the patients that are in need.
You would think that they would be all over this. Imagine all of the devastation from opioid abuse and people dropping out of society, the crime, et cetera. And you have the answer, the antidote, literally, to that problem. From a state perspective, I would think they'd be all over this because they would save money. They would have productive citizens. I mean, this is like a no-brainer, right? That's what I think.
That's kind of, exactly. That's kind of my thought. You know, I think it just goes right back to, you know, the beginning of the call when we talked about it. The root of the problem is people that are just ignorant. You know, they just haven't allowed themselves to be educated on the benefits. You know, all they're thinking is, you know, they don't want their state to become a high state.
Mm-hmm.
But cannabis has so many other health benefits on top of being able to manage pain and the various, you know, health conditions that we listed a few of. Many people don't know that, you know, cannabis really is a beautiful anti-aging compound. Our skin, we're constantly bombarded by free radicals, right? Whether
mm-hmm.
it's the air that we're breathing, the cosmetics that we're using, I mean, the list just goes on, right? But cannabis is really rich in antioxidants, and it can neutralize all of those harmful toxins that we're exposed to every day, and it will protect our skin from damage. You know, as we age, our skin secretes less oil and becomes dry, but marijuana is beautiful as a moisturizer, and actually has been proven to be effective in treating conditions as simple as eczema and psoriasis. That in itself, I think, is huge. People don't realize that it regulates blood pressure. You can actually maintain healthy body weight if you're utilizing medical cannabis. Now, a lot of people are thinking, well, I don't know. You know, I hear you get the munchies, so I might gain weight. Well, that comes from the THC aspect of it. But what happens is the CBD and the THCV that is in the cannabis actually increases people's metabolism. So
oh.
You're able to, yeah, right? You're actually able to maintain a healthy body weight. It also, whoever is utilizing medical cannabis is 30% less likely to develop type 2 diabetes, which, I mean, if you look at the onset of diabetes in today's world, it's huge. That in itself is an epidemic. So we are helping to eliminate, adding to that, the more exposure we get to people utilizing the benefits of medical cannabis. Cannabis also strengthens bones and protects joints. People don't realize that, but it absolutely has been proven to give protection against things like osteoporosis. Look at all the people that are affected by that. That in itself is terrible. People have all kinds of nerves, you know, that have pain, and the cannabis protects all your joints. It reduces inflammation. One thing that a lot of people deal with, we hear it, you know, even with patients that come in for these other conditions, almost always suffer from migraines.
Mm-hmm.
And migraines is one of the most receptive conditions to cannabis. And I mean, there's so many facts. If you research medical marijuana, medical cannabis, the different studies, the different things that we're finding about it, you'll be shocked at what it can be used for. Many people don't realize that cannabis protects the brain from trauma. And actually, there was a leading Harvard researcher, his name was Grinspoon. He wrote an article to the NFL, and his suggestion to them was to allow NFL players to consume mm-hmm. medical cannabis mm-hmm. to combat the head trauma. Mm-hmm. But, you know, how many of them are dealing with that post life in the NFL.
Right.
So that in itself is huge. Cannabis or cancer has already been proven that cannabis can turn that around. What you've got is THC that helps increase our protection of something that's called ceramide, and that's a little molecule that kills cancer. So ingesting the THC as a cancer patient, you're actually going in and destroying cancer cells. The CBD part of the plant is actually what will prevent cancer cells from spreading. So that in itself is good to know about cancer. People that are going through chemotherapy pain, it's going to deal with that, and it's going to inhibit any kind of new tumor growth. So there's a lot to be said about cannabis outside of the mindset that, you know, we're all just a bunch of hippies trying to get high, because
right.
it's far from that. It is a true, true medicine.
I mean, everything you just said, it just blows my mind, because people are on all of these prescription drugs to treat these things, and they actually don't do them. So they're, I mean, if you take a reflux medication, you're more likely to get osteoporosis or magnesium deficiency. All of the controlled toxic portions of these medications, I don't know if they're even controlled, because as you described at the beginning of the show, people are taking other medications to treat the side effects of other medications. And instead of treating the symptom, you just described a treatment that treats the problem. That is complete.
Yeah.
That is natural health. That is integrative medicine, functional medicine in a nutshell, instead of all these steroids mm-hmm. that suppress. And I mean, I have tons of friends all of a sudden with autoimmune diseases. How does it work
yep.
for those? Because that's an inflammatory condition, and is cannabis something that would be helpful for them?
Absolutely, absolutely. The list goes on. I tried to count all of the conditions that I could find any type of research or testimonial or anything, and the list just went on and on and on and on and on. You've got a plant that's got over 500 compounds to it, and so you can imagine that the different variables with, you know, how much CBD versus THC versus CBN versus, you know, all the different compounds, the conditions that we're able to treat and can be benefited from, I think it is endless.
And that's amazing. So we're going to take a break in a few minutes, but I want to start the conversation. You know, not all doctors know about this. Not all doctors are created equal. How do we find doctors who know what they're doing? I mean, you have seminars. You have, I think, do you offer seminars for doctors to come and learn about or be certified in this and understanding the treatment?
The state of Florida has their own program to certify doctors. It's not very expensive. It doesn't take much time. But I will give a little warning to those who are our doctors looking to take that test, expecting to have great knowledge at the end of it. It's a two-hour course, and it doesn't teach them anything about the plant.
Mm.
We do seminars, absolutely, and I encourage anybody to either reach out to us via our website, which is tetrahealthcenters.com, or give us a phone call at 855-440-5500. Our website does list events, or you can just call and speak with any of our staff, and they'd be happy to fill you in on what we have coming up next.
Well, do you have to be a Florida doctor to do it, or do other doctors come from other parts of the country to come and be, you know, trained and educated?
You have to be a Florida resident in order to, a resident and physician, MD or DO, to take the test. And in order to be a patient in Florida, you have to be a resident of Florida.
Okay. Do you, well, the corollary to that is, do you see your Tetra Health Centers moving out of Florida and having other locations throughout the country?
Ideally, yes. We're moving into, we've got, you know, so many things on the horizon for Tetra Health Centers, and absolutely we will be not only a nationwide but a global option for people. But it may look a little bit different than it does today, and we're excited about where we're going. I'm not going to divulge what our plans are yet, as they're not, you know, everything is not penciled out exactly, but what I can tell you is my goal is to be able to benefit as many patients as possible and to educate as many people as necessary to eliminate all of these roadblocks that patients are seeing in trying to get to their medicine.
I couldn't have said it better, and it's an admirable goal. I wish you Godspeed in doing it. We need your help. On that note, let's take our last break. You're listening to Medicine on Call.
If you've tried taking over-the-counter medications but still have problems with nasal congestion, recurrent sinus infections, sinus headaches, or a dry mouth when you wake up in the morning, why not fix the problem? From natural integrative treatment to minimally invasive surgery, Peachtree ENT Center will work with you to find the solution that works best for you. Call 404-591-9100 today to make an appointment, or visit us at PeachtreeENTCenter.com, because Peachtree ENT Center is where patient care counts. Are you having problems with persistent bad breath, constant throat clearing, hoarseness, a cough that won't go away, a sore throat, or a feeling that something's always stuck in your throat? Why not find out what the problem is so it can be fixed? At Peachtree ENT Center, we believe in taking time to work with our patients as a team to get to the root of the problem. Make an appointment today to see why Peachtree ENT Center is where patient care counts. Call 404-591-9100 or visit us at PeachtreeENTCenter.com.
You can catch the show on iTunes, Stitcher, and Spotify. Subscribe and share it with your friends.
You're listening to Medicine on Call, where healthcare, business, and current events connect.
Welcome back to Medicine on Call. I think before the break, we were really delving into the possibilities, and I can see a future where people actually will be able to stay healthy. You know, it's about prevention, but even more so, be cured. And we can't use the word cure these days, you know, because of people coming after you. But treating the problem in a way that is holistic and restorative, which is a different mentality than masking something. And in that same thought, are you getting any pushback from the typical players, the pharmaceutical mindset where it has to be prescription, otherwise it's not real? Is there any roadblock from that standpoint to what you're trying to do?
Absolutely. You know, and I don't like to step on toes, and I don't like to, you know, speak negatively, but people need to understand that, you know, Big Pharma's got a big stake in the medicine industry. You know, that's their livelihood. And if Big Pharma is being affected by cannabis sales, that is going to breed a lot of challenges and roadblocks. But you've also got, you know, so many doctors and healthcare professionals that have been trained in that arena, right? They've been trained to give these prescriptions for these opioids and other medicines. And certainly they feel like they are serving the community, and I appreciate everything they're doing. But the roadblock is when they don't have an open mind enough to look at the benefits of cannabis and add that. You know, I think you're going to have not only doctors that are against using cannabis in any way, shape, or form, but you're also going to have patients that are in the mindset that cannabis is bad for us, and so they don't want to partake. So I think, again, we go right back to the the root of the problem is people that are uneducated. So, yes, legislatively there is a challenge, and, you know, we've got Ron DeSantis, who is actually trying to make some headway. As I stated earlier, the only form of medical cannabis that is not allowed in the state of Florida is the true flower, and he's proposed that we eliminate that and allow people to not only smoke but grow their own flower. That's going to do a couple of things for people. That's going to allow them any modality that they choose to take their medicine in, but it's also going to allow them to, if they choose to grow, maybe reduce the cost of their medicine by a little bit, which, you know, I think every dollar counts for every person. You know, it doesn't matter what your financial standpoint is. You're going to benefit if everything costs you less. So, mm-hmm. I think when we look at legislature in the state of Florida, there's been a lot of challenge. It's been a very, very difficult road to hoe, if you will, thus far. I mean, we're coming up on almost 3 years when more than 71% of the population voted this in, and we still are not reaping the benefits of the full amendment being allowable. So I'm hopeful that we're going to see a lot of movement in the patient's direction in the next year. We're also looking at the elimination of what they call the vertical integration. So when Florida became legal, it was required by all license holders, which are actually the dispensaries, to do what's called seed to sale. So they actually had to plant the seed, they had to cultivate it, harvest it, then they had to break it down, extract the oils, create the product, and sell retail. That's all put on that one licensee. Well, that doesn't necessarily work. I mean, everybody's got their own gift, right? Mm-hmm. You're probably better at podcasts than I am, and I may be better at, helping patients in a medical clinic than maybe you might be or the next person. Mm-hmm. So patients are going to benefit if we find whoever does the best job at growing the plants, and then we find the best person at extracting the oils. We find the best, you know, you get my drift. So that's going to also benefit the patient. And I think we're also going to see a little bit of a price drop on products once that happens, because the burden is not just on one person trying to do a good job at all things.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, the answer to your question is I certainly have dealt with, I think everybody in this industry has dealt with, roadblocks of people who are against using cannabis rather than traditional medicine. But I also think those that are embracing it, that community is growing, and I just see it getting better.
I love that. And one of the things that we preach on the show is it's choice. Not everything works for everybody. And just the ability to, as an individual, be able to pursue what works best for you, it should be like the mantra. You know, even the drug companies tell you that not all their products work for every patient the same way. So why should they expect a monolithic healthcare system? I think, again, it's you're offering an alternative for those who are enlightened and for those that hopefully will become enlightened in the future. It just gives them options. And I would think, and correct me if I'm wrong, is this just for people, or do people have to pay out of pocket for this, or is there any coverage from an insurance standpoint if it's medically necessary?
At this point, it's 100% out of pocket. It's federally, it's classified poorly. Once we can declassify it, I think we're going to get some insurance coverage, but right now it's in the same class as, you know, opium, you know?
Yeah, that's
so
wrong.
It's very wrong. And again, I think that's just another roadblock. You know, Big Pharma doesn't want us to stick our hand all the way into the mm-hmm. pocket. And so, they're definitely fighting that, but I think if we can declassify, then we're going to see a lot more people benefiting from it. But at this point, yes, it is out of pocket.
And just a corollary question again, because I'm kind of curious. People are talking about recreational marijuana, and some of the states are passing that. I would be curious to know what you think about that as opposed to the medicinal, the medical side.
Well, you know, that's a really tough one because, you know, it gets very political. Mm-hmm. But what I can tell you is this. My personal experience is that a medical patient, which, you know, we see, you know, on average 30 to 35 a day, that are true medical patients. They have these needs that are beyond anything you've ever experienced before. And I encourage anybody to come sit in our clinic and just see these patients. When it goes recreational, those patients are going to end up losing out on having a doctor or a clinic full of a medical staff that walks them through this entire journey from start to finish, because it will not allow most of those doctor's offices to stay open. So do I agree with recreational? I think my position is medical. I'm here to serve medical patients, mm-hmm. and that's my job, is to give them the care and the support that they need, help them to be educated, and really hold their hand so the fear of this medicine goes away and they feel that somebody's got their back. That's my job, and I feel like if it goes recreational, those patients are going to be left to their own device, and that's not always a good thing.
No, I absolutely agree. And then, you know, you have one kind of an outlier, and it defines the whole industry, you know? And I think people look for the worst-case scenario and then paint the brush, use that to paint everybody with the same brush, and I don't appreciate that either. I want people to know how they can find your website, and if they're blessed enough to live in Florida, how they can find your offices.
Absolutely. The website is tetrahealthcenters.com. You can find us on Facebook, Tetra Health Centers Florida. And if you'd like to reach out and give us a call and ask questions, we're happy to help any way we can. 855-440-5500.
And I noticed also on your website, there's a blog with really great articles. People need to go there and check it out because it's about educating yourself. This is just a small snapshot of really how big of a benefit this is. And I think people, you have to do your own research. And it's a nice place, very user-friendly, easy to read. And I think that gets everybody started on their journey.
I agree. And there's many, many, many conditions that are covered in those blogs. They go back, till I believe we started those early 2015 and did two to three a week. So you're absolutely right. And that was the goal, is to have a resource for people to get educated.
I'm all about that. It's about education and self-fulfillment and, you know, living your best life, right? That sounds kind of cliche, but in this day and age, you got to do it. Every day counts.
I always say, you know, we want to help people either love the life they're living or get back into the life that they're living. Because many patients are not living a life, you know. They're sitting by a clock waiting for the timer to go off for when they're supposed to take their next med. And that's just no life. But mm-hmm. cannabis can eliminate that and actually get them back into living a life.
That'd be awesome. I know we have a minute left, but I'm curious again, for my sake, for my patients here in Georgia, is there any, I know they can't, if they don't live in Florida, they can't use your services. Is there any other locations throughout the country that you, since if you're not there, you can recommend, or a resource that they can find something in their own state?
Absolutely, there are. I encourage people to just Google medical marijuana clinics or physicians, and that'll bring them to a whole list of people that are in their area. And I encourage people to give a call and find out if they'll be meeting with an actual physician or if they'll be meeting with, you know, maybe a nurse. And I don't mean that in a disrespectful way, but I think that a medical patient with questions and medical needs really should be able to utilize the time and education of a physician.
You know, I absolutely agree with you on that one myself. I want to thank you so much for coming on. I really appreciate everything that you do. And I'm looking forward to actually coming down and maybe attending one of your seminars, because I'm all about education. I want to be on the cutting edge, and I want to help my patients whenever I can.
Absolutely. We'd love to have you. Reach out to me, and I'll get you a front row seat.
Oh, I look forward to that. Thanks once again, and I hope you have a wonderful day, and I want to thank everybody for listening to Medicine on Call. You can subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen on Stitcher, Spotify, and follow me on Facebook and DrElenaGeorge.com. Thanks for listening. Have a wonderful week.
Revolutionary talk for revolutionary times. Promoting peace, liberty, and prosperity around the clock. LibertyTalk.fm.